Welcome to this demo on Tosca data integrity and how we support unstructured data in data warehouse testing. Tosca data integrity is a layered approach to data warehouse testing, identifying issues as early as possible with end-to-end automation. This includes any file and database type hosted on-prem and in the cloud. Tosca DI has a purpose-built executor to normalize data, then use in-memory caching to store data at runtime and flush on completion. This is useful in the following use cases: testing large volumes of data, such as millions of records and terabytes of data. The data is paged in and out of memory as needed to optimize performance. To load and normalize structured, unstructured, and message data, files are loaded into the caching database and temporarily stored into tables. Aggregating multiple data sources to combine files and databases into a single source. Once data is loaded, it can be used for validations and row-by-row comparisons against any other data source. Here we see an example of unstructured data. UIF data is stored into two files. There is a UIF definition file, which defines how to read the structure of the data in the CIF data file. These files will change based on third parties, so we need a dynamic way of reading the definition file to extract and normalize the data. Tosca DI will first read the definition file for the custom defined data types. Next, it reads the data file with different record types based on the definition file. Now we write the data into a caching database based on the definition for each record type into table format. We can then use Tosca DI's standard capabilities to create and execute data validation tests on the CIF data against any other data source. Let's see how this works. Let's have a look at our use case. We want to ensure that the original data loaded in from our data source matches the data later in the warehouse as it was moved and transformed, to ensure that data integrity has been maintained. So if I open up Windows Explorer, here we can see our two files. And in this example, I will be comparing it to a SQL Server database later in the warehouse. If I open up my Excel spreadsheet and my notepad, we can see the definition file and the text file with the actual data. The definition file will define the actual data and how it's structured. So you can see it starts off with D. And as we move through it, it'll tell us the number of characters, the data types, such as CIL, and you can see a data over here. I won't go into too much detail, but all the information required to read this data and the different structures is located in this Excel spreadsheet. And as I scroll down, you'll see different data structures. And if I scroll down the data sheet, you'll see we have 52 sets of data. I'll close this down. And we can open up Tricentis Tosca in our data integrity section. We have out-of-the-box modules to do different types of data warehouse testing, to deal with databases, such as structured data in database form, files, message data. But when it comes to unstructured data, we can create our own modules to deal with this type of data, for example, our UIF data source. If I select my module over here and open up, I can bring in my description quickly. And we can see we need to load the definition file and the data file in order to flatten the structure into a table format so that we can use our standard modules for our standard row-by-row comparison testing. If I expand below here, I've already set up my test with the actual compare later. We want to focus on how we deal with the unstructured data in the UIF format. I have my module over here. I will drag and drop it into my empty folder, select my test to bring it into focus, and this is the test step we're going to be working with. The first step is to load the actual definition file, so I right-click and start my data load wizard. Over here I'll navigate to the actual Excel spreadsheet, load up the definition file. And this here, I can adjust the rows and columns to match the actual data and how it's stored. So this is dynamic, and we can change this if the structure of the actual definition file changes. In my case, my field length column is number 5, and once I've corrected that, you can see it's going to create 10 different tables with the different names seen here. I click Create Step, and Tosca will now use that information from the definition file to create my table structure. And you can see this is the different structure we'll see when the table is created in my caching database, which relates back to the data in the datasheet in the definition file. I now need to provide the file path for the actual data. So I'll come over here. Copy, paste the file, and I can run my test step, and I'll run it in stages so we can see the data being loaded first, and then we'll move on to the row by row compare. In this example, the data will be loaded to my caching database here, which I've set up. If I open up the caching database just to get a preview, we can see the 10 different tables in the related structures. I close that down, go back to Tosca. My data's all been loaded successfully with my 52 rows. I can close, and now using our standard row by row comparison module, instead of pointing to the file itself, my source will be my caching database, and I will join the first two tables together, and my target will be my SQL Server database with my queries. I can adjust row options, column options, cell options to take care of basic transformations and formatting, remapping column names, row keys, adjust tolerances, exclude columns, and a number of other options built into the module to reduce the amount of SQL querying. And we'll also generate a report in HTML format, which will be easier to identify any issues if they occur. If I scroll back up to the top, the data is already loaded, so I can now run the second part of my test, which is comparing the data. I'll move over to my reporting section. Now Tosca DI will compare the caching database to SQL Server, and we can see it's doing this all in memory. The verification was successful. It compared all the data together, and the HTML report was generated. And we can see the source and the target comparison using our SQL query. And if there was any errors, we would see them in the differences, or if we lose data from source to target, we would find them in the related tabs over here. So that was just one example of how we can deal with unstructured data. Thanks for watching.